simulation hospital, we have 4 medical surgical rooms. They have all high fidelity simulators. We have an obstetrics, 2 obstetric labor and delivery mannequins, pediatrics, a full nursery. We have Simman 3G with the ER ICU. We have everything from ventilators to AccuChecks to crash carts that are all functioning, computers on wheels, electronic medical records, medication management system, scanning. We try to do everything that we see in our community hospitals. We opened up this hospital in February of 2010. It was an awesome experience that our school, our college, embraced technology and how to bring the cutting edge here to Harper. And this is one example of excellence in education. Our students are put in a realistic situation, a hospital setting. We try to reenact what they're going to see in their community hospital experiences, diabetics, seizures, neuro. And we give them a safe environment. That's really important that they can learn. So they have classroom, they'll learn about it, and then we'll transform it right here in the hospital, make it realistic.
We have a very unique opportunity to have simulation integrated in all of our nursing courses. There are, as I mentioned, 300 students, and in each of the nursing courses, we do have simulation included in their courses in the lab. Simulation does offer the students the opportunity to practice in very unique situations. They are involved in situations in which they can make an error, and it's a safe environment for the nursing students to practice.
Are you okay? Oh, he's bleeding.
Oh!
I'm gonna need help in here. He pulled out his central line. And you pressure dressings and a mask.
Oh.
When we do simulations here in the hospital, we get to have as close to real life experience as possible. So we get to put our hands on our patients, put our hands on the equipment, learn about what's going on with them and how to intervene with it. And it gives us an opportunity to do it in a practice setting, so then we could take it out to the hospitals and do it in our real life experience. I feel like we are getting opportunities to perform skills and tasks that we otherwise wouldn't have, and to come back and practice it as many times as we need to. I think it's state of the art. I think it gives the students here a really great opportunity to learn, to practice, to become very proficient at the nursing practice. I feel like it really gives us an advantage over other students who may not have access to facilities like this.
It was actually the simulations that helped me realize that I was in the right area, because it really helps to put things into perspective of what you will see when you actually go to the hospitals, and it helps you to feel a little bit more prepared in an actual scenario.
No, Henry, would you give me some?
Sure, absolutely.
Oh, Henry.
What's wrong?
Did you just have, he's just throwing up a little bit. Henry, what did you have
for? Did I do something?
What did you have to eat, Henry?
These mannequins are incredible. They breathe, you can hear lung sounds, bowel sounds, we can put IV fluids in them, we can draw blood from them. As you saw, the mannequins can vomit, they can hemorrhage, they can seize, they can become blue, some of them sweat. It's amazing what these mannequins can do.
Okay, here we go, Dad, here we go, come take a look, Okay, here we go, we're gonna go ahead and start. Alright, here comes the shoulder. Big push, big push, big push, big push, big push, big push, big push. There we go. Alright, Dad, you want to cut the cord?
Compared to lecture or lab, it just definitely throws us in there, and we really have to put everything we've learned together into one situation. So it definitely shows you how much you're retaining, what you need to work on, your strengths. I feel very lucky to be part of it, and I was really glad that they had finished it before we graduated so we could utilize it as much as we could.
It's really good practice to have a hospital setting, because if you forget certain things or if you mess up, you're not doing it on a real patient.
We've gotten experience with critical care patients, emergency patients. We've learned how to take care of laboring women and children who are sick.
Working with the teachers the way that you have to in the simulation has also helped my learning experience. It's put me at more of a comfortable situation where I can ask them questions and I can get feedback from them that I normally wouldn't be able to.
I think that this is part of the current practice. I mean, this is the expectation. This is evidence-based practice. This is information that the students need to have to be able to practice in the acute care environment.
The most important thing is safe patient care, that they've come from Harper, graduate, being safe practitioners, even simple things like hand washing, being compassionate, good communication skills, safety above all, embracing patient care.